Evening, the family at the centre of historical rape claims against the Attorney General has in the last few hours come out in support of an independent inquiry. But the Prime Minister was today still standing by Christian Porter, who denies the claims. We now know more about the timeline of these historical allegations here in New South Wales. The latest information from police is February last year, the alleged victim met with the sex crime squad at King's Cross, the first of five meetings. But in June, she sent an email stopping the process. A day later, officers responded. A day after that, she was dead. Our political editor, Peter Van Onselen, reports.
It was high vis and high stakes in the Hunter as the Prime Minister backed his Attorney General.
He rejected the allegations very clearly.
Christian Porter has denied the historical allegation he raped a 16-year-old girl in Sydney while attending an international debating tournament. She died last year, a 49-year-old woman. Her family says they support any inquiry that could shed light on the circumstances surrounding her death.
This cannot be the end of the matter.
The South Australian coroner is yet to make a decision on an inquiry, having deemed the police investigation incomplete. Scott Morrison is ruling out an independent investigation established by the parliament.
There's not some other process. There is not the mob process. There is not the tribe has spoken process.
While New South Wales police don't have enough admissible evidence to proceed with a criminal investigation, the strike force reiterating the woman asked for them not to proceed, citing medical and personal reasons.
The matter now should be put to rest.
He has the Prime Minister's support and he has my support.
The Prime Minister is also standing by his Defence Minister, whose staff complained about her describing alleged rape victim Brittany Higgins as a lying cow.
They were made in her private office in a stressful week, and they weren't made in a public place, and nor were they intended for that.
Senator Reynolds says she's never questioned Ms. Higgins' account of her alleged sexual assault, but she did comment on news reports regarding surrounding circumstances that she felt had been misrepresented. The 26-year-old has called the comments incredibly hurtful, saying that sort of behaviour and language is never excusable.
And I think she's finished. Her career's done.
It's obviously not an acceptable comment. I think the minister needs to respond publicly.
Which may not be for another week when Parliament resumes. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.
And if you or someone you know is experiencing a personal crisis or thinking about suicide, there is support. You can call the Lifeline 24-hour crisis hotline, number 13 11 14.